Here's Faraway by Pete Young or Young, which is a lovely waltz in B minor. Works very well on the C-sharp D box. So there we are, we get to use a lot of chords in this, and rhythmically the tune is quite interesting because we get some things called hemiolas, which I will talk about a bit in a minute. Let's just start off, I'll show you the fingering for the melody for the first part before we get onto basses. Now, very important to use certain choices of fingers, particularly in this opening section. We'll use the outer row C sharp quite a bit. And that is because we'll be doing it against a chord of F sharp minor actually. And you can get a complete chord of F sharp minor on the C sharp D box with these notes here. C sharp, push, A and F. So to play against that nice chord of F sharp minor, we need to use the outer row of C sharp. So here's the first little phrase. Time. Next phrase. Here we're using another C sharp, but we're using the pull one on the row because we'll be playing an A chord from the beginning. Start again. Again, outer row C sharp. And the little rundown here. Now that is what I think the correct term for that is a hemiola. We have six eighth notes in the 3-4 bar here, or six quavers if you like. But they're divided into two groups of three. So it's almost as though we're playing two beats in the bar instead of the usual three. Dum, 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 dum. One, two, dum. And that's a very satisfying rhythmic difference to make here. So it's... And it's also very satisfying to dance a waltz and put in some hemiolas like that. It means you suddenly, you spin and you do two turns, pivoting on your balls of your feet in the bar of three. So it's one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, one, two, three, like that. So that's what we're doing here. So really make the most of it. So let's look at the chords there. We're going to start with B minor. You could start with F sharp with the leading note. So it's B minor to F sharp minor. Again, sorry. Now, straight away, you can play waltz-type accompaniment more or less through the whole way through the tune. It works quite well if you want to do that. But for the most part I prefer not to. I sometimes hint at it, but for the most part I'm using block chords because I think it gives the tune more drive. So the chords that we need are B minor to F sharp, B minor to A, and then B minor to F sharp again, for the rundown. D, A, B minor. You can either do chords and bass, or if you're feeling less dramatic, just the bass notes. So that's the whole first part there with basses. Now, second part melody. Start from the beginning again. Again. So those two phrases together sound like this. Repeat. Another hemi over here. I'll talk about this a bit more because you may not be used to hearing the tune this way. But let's do that again. The hemiola this time is D, C sharp, B, C sharp, B, A, to B. So that whole first part of the second part, first phrase, it goes like this. Then we go on and it ends differently this time. There's this rundown here, which is comprised of two bars of hemiolas, if you like. And so we've got four chords, each with three notes each, three eighth notes. And the first one's B minor, with F sharp on the pull here, A, so the B minor is pull, push, push, pull, push, pull, and the A is pull, pull, push. Then we go to G, so that's push on the D, so those three make. We get an A, now you've probably heard this tune played with that last rundown, the two bars of hemiolas, repeated twice, and I think that's the way the composer, Pete Young, wrote the tune, because that's the way it appears in a very early printed version in Bill Matheson's Waltz book, Volume 1. And in a lot of sessions I've heard it played like that. I don't know how I came by this extended second part. A lot of us up in Montreal, although not so much nowadays, have played the tune that way. And I think it's more interesting because you save that delicious rundown for the end and you get another variation of hemiolas in the middle. So the way that the Montreal way, the old Montreal way of playing this tune, second part, time you'll just hear it played. And then that repeated. And I think it's a shame because that final rundown is dramatic and it is a lot of fun, and why do it too often? It's a lovely line, save it for the end. So let's just do chords for the second part here. Push, pretty much all D and A for the first couple of bars. Now, if you have a push G for the hemiola, G, A, B minor. If you don't have a push G, you'd have to do a D. Doesn't sound quite so punchy. Kieran going on. As before. And we come to our little rundown. So B minor. A. G. A. Back to F sharp. Now, if you don't have a push G, I guess this isn't going to sound so good. You could go land on the pull G towards the end of the phrase, but it's a bit awkward. So, go and get your box converted to a push G here. Push pull, of course. So there we are, that's chords for the second part. So have fun with the tune, I'll just play it for you a couple of times, and it's been rather a long video, sorry about that, but I've been talking too much.